water striders, hopping effortlessly across the water surface. But have you ever wondered how they float on water? Well, it turns out it's all about the buoyancy. Talking about buoyancy, we must talk about Archimedes, the ancient Greek mathematician and inventor who discovered the principle of buoyancy. Yes, it was the guy who ran naked through the streets of Syracuse shouting "Eureka!" over 2,000 years ago. Archimedes' principle states that an object submerged in a fluid is acted upon by a buoyant force, making that object rise or move upward. The word buoyant comes from the Spanish word boyar, meaning to float. To simply put, the buoyancy enables the object to float or at least to seem lighter. When you put an object in a container filled with fluid, the volume of the displaced fluid is equivalent to the volume of an object submerged in that fluid. The weight of the displaced fluid is equivalent to the buoyant force. If the weight of an object is less than that of the displaced fluid, the object floats, as in the case of a block of wood in water or helium-filled balloon in the air. If the weight of an object is the same as that of the displaced fluid, it will not sink or float. Its buoyancy is the same as its weight. If the weight of an object is heavier than that of the displaced fluid, then its buoyancy is less than its weight. It will sink. This explains why pebbles do not float in water. Wait a minute, how about a ship? How does it float on water? Well, although a ship may be made of steel, which is more dense than water, it floats because it encloses a volume of air and the resulting shape has an average density less than that of the water. What if the ship is loaded with cargo, you may ask? Well, as the ship is loaded, it sinks deeper, displacing more water. The ship sinks into the ocean until the weight of the water it displaces is just equal to its own weight. The buoyant force continuously matches the weight of the ship and its cargo. So what is the famous Eureka story of Archimedes? Over 2,000 years ago in Syracuse, King Hiero II suspected that a solid gold crown he ordered was partly made of silver. The king asked Archimedes to determine whether or not the crown was pure gold without destroying the crown. Archimedes was perplexed but found inspiration while taking a bath. As he entered into the bathtub filled with water, he noticed the water level rising. The water displaced by his body was equal to the weight of his body. Suddenly, he realized that he found the solution to the problem. Because gold weighs more than silver, he reasoned that a crown mixed with silver would have to be bigger to reach the same weight as one composed only of gold. Therefore, it would displace more water than its pure gold counterpart. He was so excited, forgetting that he was undressed, he went running naked down the street from his home to the king shouting "Eureka!" which means "I found it" in Greek. Was the crown made of pure gold? To find out the crown's volume, Archimedes immersed the crown in a bucket filled with water and measured the volume of the displaced water. Then he took a bar of pure gold of the same weight and compared the volume of displaced water. Surprise, surprise, the crown displaced more water than the piece of gold, which means that the crown was a mixture of gold and silver. You can probably guess as to what happened to the goldsmith who made the crown. Submarines are designed to travel while completely submerged underwater, and they rely on the Archimedes principle in order to maintain a constant depth. In submarines, ballast tanks are used to control the buoyancy of the vessel. The amount of water filled will determine the depth to which the submarine can dive, so that they may float or sink as desired. Well, as for the water striders, their legs are so buoyant they can support 15 times its weight without sinking. Wow, that's incredible. Well, that's it for today. Thank you for watching.